Right, folks, we're back to football. It's been a long month of football. Didn't get me wrong, the World Cup was good.
Aye, most exactly.
So it kept the juices flowing for the football. But Hibs are back in action today against Livingston. We're at Easter Road. We're just about to go and get the train now. So, obviously far too early to work out the lineups. I think our lineup isn't going to be far off the ones that started against Rangers. So, to the SPFL, Nisbet's back.
You guys are so screwed now.
So, obviously I've got the feeling Nisbet's back with a wee bit of a point to prove. Do you know what I mean? Get us Hibs back scoring again. Hopefully we can get a little bit of a Christmas present, son. And stop this run of loses and draws and get a wee win under our belt before Christmas.
Well, Christmas is the time of giving, and it's time that Hibs get us something to cheer about.
Exactly, exactly. That, and we've got a really tough run of fixtures coming up. So it'd be really handy to pick up a win right now. So when we get the fixture, when we get the lineup, as normal, it'll be up on the screen. And nothing else to do, but getting that train and get the high bees. Start singing for the high bees. So hope everyone's enjoying the run up to Christmas. And obviously if we can show the highlights, we can. If we don't, then you'll see your mugs again. Trying something new. We've took away this little time sensitive light and we've put my son's light there. See how this works out, see how the timing of it all works out. So anyway, because it's Christmas Eve, I'm no one to indulge too much into everything, but 4-0 victory, we've got to talk about it. So we are going to talk about it. So let's go in chronological order. Straight for the first whistle, I thought we were the better team by a complete and utter margin.
Didn't we have like a chance on goal in the first 5 minutes?
First minute? First 30 seconds actually, but for the kickoff, Newell gave it to Porteous, who then launched it to Yuan, who played it across the goal mouth, and it was almost like, it was Hibs telling Livingston, we are coming for you in this game. So, Nisbet went through on goal, had a missed opportunity. I think they done the same. And it kind of looked like, ooh, we might be doing this to and fro business. But Jason Holt, ex-Jambo, got a red card. Now from where we were sitting, I thought it was a bad tackle, but I thought it was like a yellow.
Yeah, we aren't too sure.
I didn't see when he pulled out the red, I was surprised. I was happy, but I was surprised. I didn't know, so I'm going to have to.
I was expecting a yellow. It's possible that maybe his studs were up, but we haven't had a look at the replays yet.
Because we said that at the time, I says we would need to see the replays.
Especially with future stuff, we'll need to have a look at the replay of that with stuff we'll be discussing later.
As you know, we just say the truth. If we agree with decisions or disagree, we'll say it. At the moment, I don't know if I agree with the red card because I've not seen the replay. But they've VAR checked it, so I'm assuming they have seen something that warrants a red card. Anyway, no long after that, we then got a free kick with Porteous, about to take it. Now, I'll be honest, I was expecting it to go into the car park. I didn't think Porteous was going to hit it well. He did hit it well. And the goalkeeper made a good save, but it landed straight to Nisbet. And what did I say before the game? Nisbet's back.
Yep.
I said it before the game. And he put one away, and the place was God bananas.
Yep.
So that was brilliant. Slowly, very closely followed by, I would probably say, the best goal of the match. Carrick got the ball wide, just drove forward. And that striking in the bottom left-hand corner was something special. And there was only a couple of minutes in between. But we were going mental, I've got to say. Because that goal was just something
bouncing.
Special.
Bouncing.
Yeah.
I believe not long after that as well.
It all came kind of within 15 minutes of each other. The ball went out to... Was it Ewan or Stevenson that crossed it in? I can't remember.
I think it was Ewan.
Crossed it in, and Kyle McGuinness at the back post headed it in, 3-0. And everyone knew it was game over. Even Livingston fans, because as soon as that goal went in, there wasn't a lot of Livingston fans there, but a lot of them left when that third goal went in.
It was like 40 minutes in as well.
Yeah. It was just that, as soon as that went in, it felt like a Christmas atmosphere. It was everyone was dancing, singing along to Block 7, just having fun.
Livingston probably didn't feel like it was Christmas, but we definitely
they
felt like Christmas for us.
They didn't feel like Christmas at all.
Very silent.
Yeah, but to be fair to Livingston fans, right, I know one probably in the last match day vlog I probably gave them a lot of crap. Especially the fans acting the clowns after the game. But I've got to say, I was expecting a harder game from Livingston.
I was expecting a much more competitive game.
I have never seen Livingston play... Well, there's a difference. I've said this to Sean on the stream. I've never seen Livingston play as badly as that. But I think Hibs made them look even worse than they actually were. Because Hibs were on another level today. Yep. Absolute other level. We were talking throughout the game. You'd be hard pushed to find the man of the match. But didn't get me wrong, man of the match was David Marshall. I think David Marshall pretty much got man of the match for saving the two penalties. He had that one-on-one chance in the first half that he saved, but he never done anything else.
Yeah, aside from that, the most he got was pass back to Stadium. That was the most he touched the ball.
Yeah. But to be fair to me, I think if you take away Kyle McGuinness's two goals, Ewan and Cadden ran the show today. Ran the show. I was hoping Ewan would have got in and scored in on the second half because he deserved a goal today.
He deserved
so it. But to me, any one of those players deserved it. But there was a part of us, after half time, we kind of thought, are we going to take the foot off the gas? Are we going to have one of these iconic, I'm going to play really good this half because I can't be bothered playing in the second half.
5 minutes into the second half, we scored our fourth.
It was... great ball in again, Ewan, and then header into the bottom corner from Kyle McGuinness.
Yep.
That is when a sea of Livingston fans has left, and quite rightly so. You go out and pay your hard money to watch your team play. You travel to Edinburgh and get absolutely thumped 4-1, and your team didn't even look like laying a glove on us. Like, didn't get me wrong. Yeah, that one-on-one chance.
I believe come half-time, wasn't the possession like 73% to Hibs?
We had 73% of the possession and 17 shots on goal, 7 on target or something. I didn't care what the final stats was. If I can find it, I'll put it up here. But they were never in it. I've never seen a Livingston side that bad. But anyway, digress, we've done that. We are debating, and we've debated at the time, we debated after the match, and we have debated in the train. We are kind of loggerheads with regards to the penalties. I thought there was a comment together with two of the Livingston players and whatever defender we had. They gave a penalty. Yeah. Now, to me, I can't say yes or no whether it was a penalty. If it was a penalty, it was a harsh one. But I would need to see it.
From where I was looking, because I was watching it the full way through, a Livingston player from the Hibs defender's left went in for a sliding tackle to try and get the ball. The thing was is that the other Livingston player to his right was jostling for control. So when the Hibs player essentially tried to go back a bit, the Livingston player tackled his own guy. But because the Livingston player was so stiff, put his hands up like this, I didn't do anything. I think that's what caused the ref to look at it. They were extremely scrunched up together. But
like I said,
the Hibs player never stuck his foot out, never went for any sort of tackle. It was only the Livingston player, and I think it's fair to say you don't get a penalty from fouling your own teammate.
Yeah.
But
I also find now that there's VAR, I wonder what they've seen. Because I was taking Sean's word for it. I still haven't seen it. I will put it in the comments below what you think. Tell us what you think. Was that a goal? Was it a penalty? Was it not? Either way, Marshall saved that.
Marshall made right. And then immediately there was a handball, yeah. Which.
Now I know for the straight away I saw your reaction and you were unhappy with it and you didn't agree in it. But when you see the replay, 100% that was a penalty. Do you know what I mean? There's no doubt in my mind. If it was the other way around about, I would be screaming for it. It was a penalty. So Livingston deserved the second penalty because it was. But did it matter anyway? Because somebody else, I think Concalves, took the first one, missed. And I think he took the second one, but they missed his game. And then that just made everything else just go dark. That was probably celebrated just as much as the goals.
Plus Marshall got to do something during the match. Exactly. That's a plus for him.
So, like I said, we weren't going to leave too long. It's Christmas Eve. We want to kind of get back to the house, enjoy our Christmas together. Yous will want to watch like more than he can when this will be out, to be honest. It might be on Christmas Eve, Christmas night, maybe Boxing Day, I don't know. Right, but we are going to be there on Wednesday to take on Celtic.
A good building block to go off of.
We really have. That performance was something special.
Absolutely.
Something special. And it's about bloody time. What a Christmas present. And then there's whispers I've heard that Craig Gordon's broke his leg thanks to Stephen Fletcher, which is just like, I know it sounds horrible to wish somebody, I hope they've broke their leg. But Craig Gordon gets them so many bloody points. And we've got them twice in January. We've got them in the league and we've got them in the Scottish Cup. So I hope you have a good Christmas, Craig Gordon, but I don't want you playing football against us. So
I think this is one of the few times where we've went off a match. We've not really had much to say other than saying what has already happened. Because there wasn't really many out there decisions. There was the penalty, there was possibly the red card, but other than that,
it was pretty much done. No, perfectly.
No perfect.
Do you know what I mean? Because there was a couple of decisions I'm like, that's a bit well. But it's nothing major. You know, we're watching our, I was going to say podcast, it's not a podcast, our video, that we talk about decisions, we talk about refereeing decisions, we talk about how the opposition played against us and how we played against them. And we're very open and honest, but today it was just a fun atmosphere. Hibs passed it beautifully. Like their passing today was, they've obviously worked on that or the World Cup. And
it seems like whenever there's amazing. A break in football, Hibs come back much better for it.
Well, I'm hoping this is a kickstart. I really am. Because like I said to Sean before we went to the game, I don't know what it is with Lee Johnson. And I've defended him in numerous videos that people post or we Hibs post and people come in and saying something. I don't know what it is with Lee Johnson, but there's something about him that I think he is the man to take us forward. And at the very least, we need to give him until the next winter window. That gives him three windows, pretty much a year and a half in charge, to get us kind of playing how he wants to do. I genuinely believe in Johnson.
And if today is any indication...
Yeah, that shows you. There was, I said on a video not long ago, I says I see something in this team, and they just need to click it. It just needs to happen. And somebody commented, I can't remember who it was, because I never went back to the comment, to be honest with you, so if it was you watching this, sorry. Busy month, being Christmas and all. But that's what I saw. When it clicks, it clicks. And by God, it clicked today.
It absolutely clicked.
And it needed to happen because we've got Celtic during the week. So, right. Anyway, we've blabbled on for a bit too long. So we're going to go home. Enjoy your Christmas Eve. Maybe I get a little drink on and whatnot. And then tomorrow, open loads and loads of presents. So, anyway. Thank you for watching. Thank you for the support this year. It's been absolutely mental. The views and the comments and everything, interactions, even interactions, just people in the street. It's madness. Do you know what I mean? To think that people actually listen to us and actually...
Listen to us babble on.
Yeah, listen to us babble on and actually have a conversation. It's mental. I love Hibs fans. There's something about us. It's just unreal. But anyway, that is us. And as normal. On to the next one.